announcements for Sunday, November 19th, 2023 are as follows. The Family and Friends Committee thank everyone for their support. Mrs. Amelia Fulton, Chairperson, Mrs. Jane Vice, Co-Chair. Florence District Leadership Training with Bishop Holston will be held on December the 7th, 2023 at 10 o'clock a.m. And it will be at Central United Methodist Church, Florence, South Carolina. All members that are asked to attend are PPRC, trustees, finance, safe sanctuaries, disaster response, and lay leaders. You need to register by November the 24th. Amen?
Amen.
November birthday captain is Ms. Carol P. Fulton. So please have your birthday donations ready for her by next Sunday. Let us remember in our prayers, with our visits and support, those persons in our family that are sick, shut in, hospitalized, those with special needs, the caregivers, and those in bereavement. What we want to acknowledge that Mr. Howard Edwards, the brother of our mother here, Ms. Fleming, is back in the hospital. So we want the church to continue to pray for the Fleming family and Mr. Edwards. We know that God has all power in his hands. Amen. And God has brought him this far, too far to leave him. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. And we would like to acknowledge Mr. Kevin Myers on this morning. Boy. He's been out in the building, but he didn't have to go. That I would like to read out. Happy Thanksgiving. Wishing you a Thanksgiving filled with the warmth of caring, the joy of togetherness, the love of friends and family, and happy memories that remain long after the season is gone. May the peace of God comfort you and strengthen you in this season. This is coming from Pastor and First Lady. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Also, I would like to announce that we have a visitor visiting with us today. I know we have one. We have Mr. Albert Williams. Mr. Albert, would you like to say anything, sir? Miss Ann.
Yeah, I'm just glad to be here.
Amen.
God is so good to us.
Yes, he is.
You know, when you look around and see how far God has brought us.
Amen.
And see, the scriptures say that same spirit that dwells in you. I feel like I'm brothers and sisters.
Amen.
You know, I don't want to take up a lot of time. I feel pretty good in the spirit.
Amen.
God is so good.
Yes. Amen.
It's a song that I know all of us know.
Okay.
Maybe the musician might have.
All right.
Mighty God be served.
Amen.
His song says, angels bow before him.
Yes.
Amen.
Yeah.
Heaven and earth adore him.
Amen.
What a mighty God.
Very sick, so we need to ask a special prayer for them.
Amen. Amen. who will remember to continue to pray for Ms. Jane Bice and her husband, David Bice, while he's going through this illness. We know it's their time right now, but it may be our time tomorrow. And anyone that has been going through anything, you know, a lot of times people are shaken in their spirit when something new comes upon them. So that's where us as Christians and those that have fought these battles and we won, we can give our testimony so we can encourage them and let them know what God can do. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. This does, in our announcements for this morning, please let, okay, Mr. Fleming.
I won't take up much of your time, but Sam, I hope I'm not stepping over you, our United Methodist men. We just want to thank you guys because we want to acknowledge that we men in the church are doing some things.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
And we plan to go some places.
All right. Amen. Amen.
But we need the help of the men.
Mm-hmm. All right.
But I want to thank y'all because last Sunday was friends and family.
Yeah.
The man made a nice donation during that occasion.
Amen.
If y'all want to know how much it is, check it with me after church. Okay, she said it was great. So I'm encouraging the Methodist man to come join us. We have a pastor standing behind us. He's leading us.
Amen. Amen.
He's really guiding us and directing us. And we have a lot of things we want to do here as men.
Amen.
Because I believe a church to have working men makes a very growing church.
Amen.
Even in the family. When the men step up, even in the family,
amen,
you can see a difference.
Amen.
So if we men step up in this church, we will see a difference.
Amen.
So I'm encouraging you. We are doing some things. So I encourage you to join us along with our pastor in the things that we could do here in Elijah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Remember the Williams family in our prayers, Ms. Liza Williams. We know that they haven't seen a lot of death lately, so let's remember the family in our prayers. And if you have a chance, if you have her number, just give her a call to one of her sisters, the nieces or nephew, and just let everybody know that we care. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
This does end our announcements for this morning. Please let us govern ourselves accordingly.
Amen.
Amen.
Burgess for those announcements, Mr. Fleming for those announcements, and Ms. Libby Barr for those announcements. At this time, will you please stand by and give a praise? Thank you. Christ be with you.
And also with you.
The risen Christ is with us.
Praise the Lord.
Now we have our affirmation of faith found on page number 881.
Believe in God the Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day He rose from the dead, He ascended to heaven, and stood at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence He shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Thank you.
our stewards come forward. Father, bless the gift of our hands we are giving. Help us to be faithful disciples who recognize that everything we have in life is a gift from you. Inspire us to share our resources in this church as a response to your unconditional love. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Don't spill the wine.
Okay. All right. Go ahead.
don't spill the wine. And if I had to use a subtopic this morning, it would be, I can't make it without you, Lord.
All right, amen.
I can't make it without you, Lord.
Amen.
We were in Samuel dealing with Hannah when her womb was shut. Mm-hmm. And she had prayed for a long time for God to open up her womb. And finally she gave birth to a young man named Hannah, who became a great prophet. Mm-hmm. And we see as time progressed, Samuel is growing the Lord and God is using him. He was lent to the house of God to do the work of the kingdom, because she promised, if you bless me and open up my womb, I will dedicate my child unto you.
Amen.
So that's exactly what she did. She actually lent her son to the house of God. And so he stayed with the priest, Eli, while she would go back to her home. And every year she would bring him something every year, because she made sure that he stayed right where God had sent him.
Amen.
But as time goes by, we see that he never really heard from God. He's just serving God in the temple with Eli. And he hears a voice calling him. And he goes to Eli, thinking Eli is calling him, and Eli lets him know, I didn't call you, God, I'm sorry. And then he comes back to him again and thinks that Eli is calling him. Eli said, no, that's not me. But then Eli perceived that it was God speaking to him. And so told him, the next time you hear the voice, then you answer to the Lord. It is good when you have people in your life that may not be what you hear, but know what God's trying to give you a word. Tell somebody. That's the kind of thing you need in your life. And so in this particular part of this particular story, I wanted to give that, because sometimes you want to be surrounded by people that may not hear what you hear, but know that God is trying to give you a word and trying to move you in a certain direction. We don't hear God the same. We don't feel God the same when God is speaking to us. And there is something specific that God maybe wants you to do, and nobody else will hear, but you got to do it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Like that song this morning, brother. Your song, that's on your song. Your song this morning. You have to let that out. Hallelujah. Oh, I love it. Hallelujah. But in this particular chapter, in chapter 5, the Philistines actually was fighting against the children of Israel. And they had already fought against them, and they took away the Ark of the Covenant. And when you know about the Ark of the Covenant, you know the Ark of the Covenant is where the presence of God was.
That's right.
It had the commandments in there, Aaron's rod in there, had the manna in there. Anywhere that Ark went, the presence of God went with it. That covenant represents a contract that God made with his people.
Yeah.
He was giving them that word and that promise, what he would do for them between that relationship. So wherever that ark went, the presence of God went, and things began to move.
Hallelujah.
But the Philistines, what happened was, the Philistines, in the previous chapter before, the Philistines heard a loud noise coming from Israel. The noise that they heard from Israel was because Israel had just brought the Ark of the Covenant back. And so when they heard that sound of that shout, the Bible said the earth even rung. They shot so hard because they knew that the presence of God was back, the earth began to ring. Boy, that you can shout so hard, it makes the earth ring. That's the sound right there. That's the sound of praise and worship. But the Philistines began to guard themselves. And they said, you know what we're going to have to do? We know that the Ark of God, the presence of God, is back in Israel. So we're going to have to fight them harder. And we're going to take away the Ark from them. We're going to take away their presence. We're going to take the word away from them. We're going to pull that contract from them. And the Bible said in the previous chapter that they slew Israel, a bunch of them. Destroyed them and beat them. And at that same time, before that, even Hophni and Phinehas, they were the sons of Eli, and they were sleeping around with a bunch of folks in the temple. And so God told him, I'm going to strip the kingdom from you. So at this time in this war, in this same war, they start destroying the children of Israel. And all of a sudden now Hophni and Phinehas get killed in the war. And then they come back and tell Eli, your sons are dead. So then Eli falls back, breaks his neck, and he dies. But then the mother of one of the young men gives birth to a child named Ichabod, which means the Spirit of the Lord has departed from Israel. Come on, something is going on. So it looks like, this because the ark, and it looks like because the Philistines are winning, it looks like they won the battle. But I want you to know something. You already know that God is already in the midst of things that's going on. And that no matter how the battle looks, come on somebody, all things work together for the good of people. They bring it to Ashdod. And they set the ark beside this statue called Dagon. It looks like a fish or some man. A lovely thing. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah. But they worship the Philistine, they worship that. But when they got up the next morning, by putting the ark right beside the statue, something happened. They woke up that morning, looked down, and that statue that they made of stone had on the floor. And the statue had fallen face down right in front of the Ark of the Covenant. Trying to let them know that even though you stole something from me, even though you stole the presence from me, it still ain't doing you no good. Hallelujah. So they fell down in the face. So they said, okay, well, we're going to go back and pick it back up. So they picked the statue back up. And then they go back the next morning, and the statue had failed again. But this time, God wanted to show them, I'm going to show you, you can put it back up if you want to, but I'm going to show you that I'm God and I'm still in control. So now the head of the statue is off, the hands of the statue are off, and his legs prostrate before God. Oh, come on, somebody. Now, to me, it seemed like they would have learned their lesson in Judges. When they had made a statue and they had it supporting the building with Samson, when they brought Samson in. And Samson, in his death, he pushed the pillows. Y'all remember the story? And he killed a bunch of Philistines, but evidently they didn't get the memo back then. So they want to try it one more time. But the same God that they delivered back then is the same God that will deliver right now. Hallelujah. But does God know how to take care of your enemy? God knows how to pass your trial. God knows how to work behind the scenes. And you don't know what's going on. Come on, somebody. This is the thing I like about it. They pull the presence away from you to make you feel like you've lost. Make you feel like you've lost the battle. So again, you lost some things, and some of the Philistines got killed. So they lost a whole lot. So it just looks like they're not winning at all. But, and that is not just like the enemy, they will get something from you, and they'll look like they're prospering. But they won't tell you behind the scenes what God is really doing.
Come on now.
Because they're not really prospering. They just look like they're prospering. Because they thought they were stripping the presence from you. They thought they were stripping the word from you. But when they bring it to their camp, now I'm in the right place I need to be to show them who is really God. Now they'll know who's on your side when I destroy their God. And they don't understand what I'm doing. They don't know who's in control. Tell somebody God is in control.
Amen.
He's in control. to you.
Yeah.
He's increasing your capacity.
Yeah.
He's trying to get you to grow to a place. We said to the morning Sunday school, he's trying to get you to the place where you learn to trust him.
Oh, yeah.
And not go on your own. Yeah. Hallelujah. Okay. The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. Yeah. And though he fall, he's not utterly cast down because God still holds him by the hand. Though the weapon form, the weapon cannot succeed. Yeah. Come on, somebody. When the enemy comes like a flood, God raises up a standard. So Matthew 9:17, we almost there. Matthew 9:17 says this. Neither do men put new wine into old wine, old bottles, else the bottle break, and the wine runneth out, and the bottles perish. But they put new wine in new bottles, and both are preserved. So what God is saying is this. I'm bringing new wine in your life.
All right, all right.
The new wine, when it starts to ferment, it starts to expand. Mm-hmm. But when it expands, you have to expand with
it. Yes.
So what they would do is they would all the outside of the bottles. Yes. So the bottles could stretch.
Yes.
While the anointing is stretching, they had to stretch too.
Yes.
But sometimes we get stiff and the enemy's trying to get us in a rut. And we don't stretch, hallelujah. We just stay kind of stiff and rigid. We don't pray. We don't worship. We don't pray. We just feel like we're going to stay right here. That's what happens if we break. And then the wine spills on the ground and nobody gets it because the enemy has it. But tell somebody, don't spill the wine. What I mean by that is you got to make sure you hold on to everything God is doing for you because he's going to use you as a testimony. Hallelujah. Job went through his life. Hallelujah. But the latter end of his life was greater than the beginning. It's kind of like a clutch, you know. Anybody know how to drive a stick shift?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Young man, how to drive a stick shift. Well, when you're driving that car and you're trying to shift, you got to press that clutch down.
Uh-huh.
But some of us have got stuck right in that clutch.
Uh-huh.
And God's trying to shift us, but we won't shift.
Oh,
yeah. And so God said, now when I put it in the clutch, I need you to shift with me. Because I'm trying to move you to a different place. Move you to a different mindset. So tell somebody in this season in my life, I'm going to shift with God. Tell somebody and tell another neighbor, in this season in my life, I'm going to shift for God. I'm going to shift with new purpose. I'm going to shift to a new mindset. I'm going to shift with a new outlook. I'm going to shift with new jobs and better jobs. I'm going to shift to new ideas. The new business. I'm going to shift a new song. I'm going to put a new song in my spirit. I'm going to shift a new skill. I'm going to sing a better song. I'm going to sing a new song to the Lord. I'm going to preach with a better ability. I'm going to sing praise and worship. I'm shifting to a new worship. I'm shifting with more words. I'm shifting with more power. Why? Because I'm expanding in God.
Yeah.
he is not waiting.
Amen.
Hallelujah. God is working behind the scenes, and he's pulling it all together. You might be struggling in your body, I don't care what it is, but you need to know that your God is working for you. And it's come, tell somebody, it's coming together. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And when I get to the end of this journey, hallelujah, I'll be like, so my ladder is. Come on, somebody. It's going to be greater than my beginning. Somebody just go ahead and pick up a phone.
We're so glad you came to save us. May we all stand.
Hallelujah, Jesus. You want to open the doors of the church this time? Maybe you don't know the Lord as your personal Savior. Here's your opportunity to give yourself to the Lord. Maybe you backslid and you want to rededicate yourself to the Lord. You want to open it up for you.
Thank you.
Christmas. We want to tell you from here, beyond closer. Don't be deceived by what you see. Don't be deceived by what you feel. You got to know that God is working in your favor. I'm telling you, you never believe God, you need to believe God. That He is working in your favor. Don't go by your pain. Don't go by anything. Don't go by what you lost. But God, our God can restore and heal to you. And it came to run the wrong from everything that destroyed your life. He'll give it all back to you. And let us look to the Lord and be distressed. Now we can hear the favor to exceed abundantly above all that we ask for you today. But it's according to the power that worketh in you. To Christ be the glory forever.